Good morning. I want to welcome our faculty, our staff, our students, graduates, and their families. My name is Claire Ward, and it is my privilege to be head of school of Shore Country Day School. We are here today in celebration of our graduates taking the next step to secondary school. If you are like me, this is your very first virtual graduation. If you were like me, you never imagined finishing the last trimester of school in distance learning mode. Graduates, you have amazed us throughout this entire journey. Through it all, you have had a chance to demonstrate every bit of our Shore community code. You persevered, you made the best of things, you remained engaged with your community, and you leaned in. Together, we held two flag raisings, a virtual heads holiday, and mastered the art of Zoom. This was quite a trip, and I am confident that while it is not what we all imagined, that you have learned independence and resilience that you might not have even thought possible. Graduates, we are committed to you taking Shore's community code with you as your most important lesson. Our hope is that you are motivated to lead with kindness, with truth, respect, openness, and dependability. So as we move through our ceremony of celebration today, I hope you will consider all of the ways you can be your Shore best as you make the exciting move to secondary school. After nearly 27 years at Shore, this year we say goodbye to math teacher Kent Veneau. We are grateful for all that Mr. Veneau has given his students and his colleagues over the years. To honor him for his long Shore career, we have asked Kent to be our faculty speaker for this year's graduation.
Good morning, Shore. This is Mr. Veneau reporting to you from the ninth grade room, bringing you Some Good News, Shore Edition. Yes, I have watched John Krasinski's episodic news show on YouTube and have borrowed this theme, as many fans of the show have done across the globe. The show reports only good news, despite difficult times, and today is all about good news. If you have not seen any episodes, you should check it out. In the Shore edition, there will be no cameos by the cast of The Office, or songs by the cast of Hamilton, or Oprah Winfrey, or Steven Spielberg, or Brad Pitt doing the weather. No, sorry, just me, a fellow graduate who's been thinking a lot about his time at Shore. Graduation is a time where we both look back and look ahead. You are undoubtedly excited to look ahead to your new school, meeting new friends, having new experiences. And I join you in feeling excitement about heading off on new adventures and challenges. And I'm confident in saying that you are all ready for whatever may come your way. Your resilience, your determination, your motivation, your flexibility during these last 2 months of distance learning were amazing. You Zoomed. You researched. You watched goofy little teacher videos, and you rose to those challenges. What more could we ask for? You rocked it. And not only that, but you made history doing it. Your teachers and parents are so proud of you for what you have accomplished and for who you are, not just during distance learning, but through all your years at Shore. We have been so lucky to see you blossom in the classroom, excel on the sports fields, share your artistic, musical, and theatrical talents. Not to mention playing foursquare with you at recess, eating lunch with you, going on trips with you, and basically watching you grow up. It is those moments that need to be recognized and celebrated, especially on this, your graduation day. And that is the true point and beauty of Some Good News, and why I am sitting here at a news desk, spinning a globe, and using handmade signs. Today's graduation is not only about looking ahead, but also about looking back at what we have gained, how we have responded to challenges, what we are grateful for, what is memorable, what we should cherish from our time at shore, and what we should take with us from our time at shore. So to make sure that you don't forget these things as you move on, I enlisted the help of my fantastic math department colleagues, and I have compiled a list in three categories of your shore memories that you should hold close to your heart as you live life after shore. And the first category is trips. Perhaps you remember laughing with friends in the hotel in Mississippi. Perhaps you remember playing with the kids in Glendora. Perhaps you remember a campfire and mosh pit at Yarmouth. It sounds right up my alley. I'm sure you remember the 8th and 9th grade outward bound trips that started this year. Some of you may remember a trip to Boston at the end of your 8th grade year with a small group of students and teachers. Perhaps you remember a 5th grade trip where some of the beds got soaked with rain. Maybe you remember a history field trip, and not for the history, but for buying 200 munchkins. Now that's a history trip I could sign up for. Perhaps you remember the 6th grade overnight trip to Hulbert in Vermont. And some of you may remember waking up at 5 a.m. to hang out with your roommates and bonding with your advisor group. And maybe some of you remember the good times that you had at your Hosmer trip in 7th grade. Second category is classes and activities. 3rd grade was a banner year for you. You remember the 3rd grade play, you remember the 3rd grade Olympics, you remember baking bread in 3rd grade, and my personal favorite, you remember digging up stuff. That sounds like an amazing year that I should probably revisit at some point. You remember singing Happy Trails at Thanksgiving. Me too. Some of you might remember students making a milkshake in science class, and I just wonder if that was part of the lesson plan. Many of you will remember participating in the musical Oliver, enjoying the experience, and being in the cast and crew. Some of you remember building straw bridges in math class. Go math. Some of you may remember track and cross-country experiences. Maybe you remember the first morning meeting of 6th grade and seeing the whole class together. I got many memories of that. Some of you remember, again in science class, a particularly funny student presentation about diphtheria, which I didn't even know could be funny. And all of you remember Heads Holiday. Some of you, it was your first Heads Holiday, and for some of you, it was Heads Holiday in 7th grade that was memorable. And the last category is what really makes shore, shore, the people, your friends and teachers. A few of you remember getting in trouble with a friend in readiness, and I didn't even know you could get in trouble in readiness. A few of you remember having a class with a best friend and sitting together in the same seats every day, all year. A few of you remember a particular student stealing a pancake. I don't know the whole story, but clearly it was memorable. A few of you remember a ticket business with a friend in 4th grade. Some of you may remember playing soccer in the rain. Maybe some of you remember the 5th grade frozen orange juice caper where you stealed away a few of those little orange juices and then into the freezer and then had a little orange slush later in the day unbeknownst to your teachers. I'm betting those readiness people were involved in that. And of course, you're going to remember your teacher's advice and encouragement throughout the years. You also remember bus rides with friends, and finally, laughing and goofing every day with friends in the upper school, during recess, during lunch, before school, after school, and of course, probably occasionally in classes too. These are just a few snippets of shared memories that make your years at shore good news. They are snapshots of your life not to be forgotten. Cherish them and all the other memories you have of your shore years. Wherever you go, whatever you do, carry a little piece of shore with you with these snapshots, for they are truly your stories of good news. Congratulations, graduates of 2020, and best of luck in your future endeavors. Come back and visit often. I know I will, and I hope our paths will meet again soon. This is Mr. Vanell signing off of SGN Shore Edition. Good day.
On this day, we officially graduate our 8th and 9th graders. Because they each reflect a unique piece of the Shore community, we are going to share individual words about each graduate in the form of gratitude. These are the collective sentiments from the faculty, the staff, and the administration. I will call each graduate by name. We will start with the 8th grade and then move to the 9th grade. Graduates, feel free to stand at home when your name is called. Wesley Roberts Card. Wesley, thank you for your steady presence and your ability to always remain grounded in what is most important. We appreciate watching you develop into a keen analytical thinker and a fine performer. Catherine June Carroll. Kat, thank you for always being able to advocate for justice and name things as they are. We appreciate watching you develop your confidence and finish the year as such a strong student. John Patrick Charpentier. JP, we appreciate your humility and maturity, traits not always as well developed in others your age. Thank you for working hard in the classroom and being an advocate for equality for all during the learning process. Lauren Ann Collins. Lauren, thank you for your dedication and your ability to bring a positive approach to all that you do. We appreciate watching you balance determination with hard work in the classroom and on the athletic field. Catherine Suzanne Culleting. Kate, thank you for being down to earth even as you take your responsibilities so seriously. We will miss your incredible musical talent, your confidence, and your humor. Joseph Rocco Donato Jr. Joey, thank you for sharing all of your musical gifts with us as both a performer and a budding composer. We appreciate your talent as a reader and writer, especially when you look at things in such unique ways. Leonardo James DiStefano. Leo, thank you for being an earnest and humble person with a great sense of humor. We appreciate watching you grow academically this year and look forward to watching you pursue your passion for writing. Charles Paul Dobbins. Charles, we appreciate your fearlessness in discussion as you work to help others make sense in a logical way. Thank you for sharing your vocal and stage talents with us during your middle school years. Tallulah Charlotte Doringer. Tallulah, we appreciate your mad math skills and your drive to do well. Thank you for always having an invested and insightful presence at the table, demonstrating the real value of your quiet style of leadership. Gabrielle Favor Ososa Idakba. Gabby, we appreciate the breadth of your dedication and skill as you demonstrate a well-developed perceptiveness and intellect. Thank you for always being a creative, generous, and empathetic soul. Owen Clark Faldi. Owen, thank you for your highly developed analytical mind, allowing you to always pursue a good debate. We appreciate your incredible growth this year and loved your leadership in lower school PE. Charles Conway Falk. Charlie, It was a pleasure watching you grow into your own as a student this year. Thank you for your creativity, your imagination, and your ability to always speak your mind when it matters most. Dylan Calvert Feeks. Dylan, thank you for your uncanny ability to collect other people by being open and earnest. We appreciate all that you have brought to shore in the classroom and on the field. Nina Adelaide Kim Finn. Nina, thank you for being the voice of reason as you quietly bring others together with your abilities as a leader. We appreciate your sense of purpose, your talent as a writer, and your well-developed empathy. Theodore Clark Fritzinger. Teddy, it is amazing to watch you develop your critical thinking skills by always considering an opposing point of view. We appreciate your eagerness and your sense of play. Marcella Ann Hernandez. Marcella, you are a humble leader whose success comes from leading by example. Thank you for exemplifying the community code and turning even the most insignificant moment or task into something meaningful. Johanna Marie Jenkins. Hannah, we appreciate your keen abilities as a thinker, something that often drives rigorous discussion in the classroom. Thank you for being thoughtful and a force to be reckoned with on the soccer field. Annika Catherine Johnson. Annika, we appreciate your work ethic and your commitment to always pursuing your personal best. Thank you for being willing to use your strong moral compass to make ethical decisions in the best interest of all. Rowan Davies Jones. Rowan, thank you for being a thoughtful person and role model for others. We appreciate your talent as a musician and your ability to stretch your imagination and creative boundaries. Abby May Joyner. Abby, thank you for being a conscientious and dedicated student who brings her best each day. We appreciate your positive spirit and your willingness to lean in even when things are not going as planned. Luke Sebastian Marinelli. Luke, thank you for always being a playful and loyal friend to all. We appreciate your budding research skills and the unassuming way you attack each new academic task. Sylvia Rendell Marks. Sylvia, thank you for being one of the most thoughtful and considerate students and athletes in the Shore community. We appreciate how you balance your drive to achieve with your passion for exploring new interests. Mark John McDuffie Jr. Mark, thank you for being a steady, respectful, and supportive presence. We appreciate your hidden sense of humor and the way in which you inspire loyalty among your friends. Sophie Ruth McDuffie. Sophie, thank you for both fully and cheerfully engaging with your academic work. We appreciate your fine math and writing skills and the ways in which you are finding your voice during discussions. Jack Michael McVeigh. Jack, thank you for being a genuine person whose smile puts those around you at ease. We appreciate the ways in which you balance play with hard work on the stage and in the classroom. Nelson Leo Meany. Nelson, we appreciate your incredible interest in history and world issues. Thank you for also sharing your creative side and for showing so much respect for others. Elise Michelle Miner. Elise, we appreciate the ways in which you think for yourself, never feeling self-conscious about taking your own path. Thank you for sharing your leadership and writing skills with your peers and your teachers. Claire Marie O'Halloran. Claire, thank you for your enthusiasm for everything you do, be it on the stage, in the classroom, or on the field. We appreciate your joy and your wonderful consideration for others. Dylan Tzu Olson. Dylan, we appreciate your high-spirited and fun-loving approach to life. Thank you for sharing your potential as an artist with the Shore community. Samuel David Porter. Sam, we appreciate the ways in which you take care of business, never taking yourself too seriously. Thank you for your punctuality and commitment during the distance learning portion of our year. Georgia Elizabeth Rossetti. Georgia, we appreciate the ways in which you both feel and express gratitude toward others. Thank you for always using your diligence, your steadiness, and your confidence to model the community code. Rachel Elizabeth Jacqueline Rubin. Rachel, thank you for your passion for social justice and your ability to tackle complex ideas in discussion. We appreciate your backstage leadership and your unique way of interpreting the world around you. Esme DeBabion Shields. Esme, we appreciate your leadership and your ability to give constructive feedback to others in a kind and thoughtful way. Thank you for sharing your fine mind and artistic talents with the Shore community. Caroline Cristoforo St. John. Caroline, thank you for being motivated to learn both in and out of the classroom. We appreciate your strong sense of self and your new confidence as an artist. Maylee Rao Staff. Maylee, thank you for your generosity as a learner, always willing to offer support to others. We appreciate your excellent math skills, your maturity, and your sense of personal responsibility. Abigail Elizabeth Stevenson. Abigail, thank you for being a strong contributor to every aspect of the Shore experience. We appreciate your curiosity, your personal warmth, and your incredible work ethic. Sadie Rose Stiles. Sadie, thank you for being a true ray of sunshine. It is no wonder that we all want to be caught up in your light, as you are encouraging, welcoming, and optimistic. The fact that you are also a force on the soccer field makes us appreciate your complexity all the more. William Bradford Sumner. Will, thank you for your energy, your sense of play, and your incredible creativity as a singer, actor, and artist. We appreciate your mental quickness that allows you to banter with both your teachers and your peers. Maya Melody Tavares. Maya, we appreciate your desire to always know why and your ability to advocate for yourself. Thank you for sharing your creativity and your willingness to be focused on the whole when you are part of a group. Andrew Joseph Tolman. Andrew, we appreciate your devotion and talent as a musician as much as we do your abilities as a thinker. Thank you for your willingness to befriend anyone in our community with your open and authentic approach. Where on earth will we be next year without your magic tricks? William Varesky Woeful. Will, although you are humble about your abilities, we see your talent as an artist, especially the skillful way you engage and entertain others with your writing. We appreciate the ways in which you have learned to believe in your own abilities this year. Zachary Fielding Weber. Zach, we appreciate your talent as a writer and your creativity as an artist. Thank you for being a loyal and inclusive person and a truly capable leader in all that you do at Shore. Alexander Ford Wilkinson. Alex, we appreciate the fact that your mind is always working to explore new angles to a problem. Thank you for your awesome skills as a conversationalist and your hard work this year. Charles Berglund Wilkinson. Charlie, we appreciate the way you fully immerse yourself into academics and how you lean in during discussion to challenge the assumptions of others. Thank you for showing us your kindness, your humor, and your artistry. Donald Seth Williamson. Seth, we appreciate your skills as a thinker and your hunger for new knowledge. Thank you for your musicianship, your compositions, and your creative curiosity. Christopher Gian Young. CJ, thank you for being a steady and humble person who always remains a reliable friend. We appreciate your incredible athletic drive and your sportsmanship. Edward Oliver Zaldestani. Oliver, we appreciate your easygoing, good-naturedness, balanced with your strong critical thinking skills. Thank you for showing us your relentlessness and keen eye on the lacrosse field. I would now like to ask the eighth grade graduates to stand. I present everyone with the graduated eighth grade class of 2020. I now welcome Mr. Carrera to pay tribute to the ninth graders.
Arden Asher Berg, thank you for your intellectual engagement and enthusiasm at the table. We appreciate your amazing leadership with younger students during house meeting. Abigail Fitzpatrick Buchler. Abby, thank you for sharing your incredible talents as a writer and a thinker. We appreciate your ability to always pursue your vision. Raphael Baxter Clark. Raph, thank you for your passionate exploration of ideas and your willingness to take creative risks. We appreciate your sense of humor and your perseverance in the face of challenge. Ethan Wood Driscoll. Ethan, thank you for always being an original, imaginative thinker. We appreciate the ways in which you engage others with grace and clarity of thought. Brooke Victoria Georges. Brooke, you're one of the kindest and most generous people we know. Thank you for your hard work and for letting us watch you boldly venture into new realms of thought this year. Eloise Helen Goodkoop. Eloise, thank you for your incredible work ethic and determination. We appreciate the way you're able to balance this with your openness and empathy for others. Margaret Ruth Hoffman. Meg, thank you for your strong critical thinking, your willingness to work hard. We appreciate your incredible talent as a performer and your willingness to lead by example on the stage and beyond. Lily Scott Eiler. Lily, thank you for always standing your ground on the things that are most important in life. We appreciate watching the way in which you used the trip to Mississippi to transform your perspective on the world. Elizabeth Joan Kemp. Elizabeth, thank you for always being someone who learns for the sake of knowledge and not the grade. We appreciate your kindness and how you treat every person according to their authenticity, never compromising your values. Benjamin Charles Lipdeck. Ben, thank you for your energy, your humility, and your effervescence. We appreciate your big heart and your willingness to be a great listener. Maris Lane Moody. Maris, thank you for your ability to always represent yourself in a true, sure way. We appreciate your leadership, your strength, and the way in which you always speak the truth. Spencer William Sullivan. Spencer, thank you for bringing life and spirit to this class. We appreciate your low-key humor, your cheer, and your incredible talent on the stage. Camila Elise Torres. Cami, thank you for always finding ways to support those who struggle with a care and a listening ear. We appreciate your passion as an artist and your authentic writing voice. Ella Maeve Williams. Ella, Thank you for your positive and cheerful attitude, for your independent intellectual outlook, and for your sense of right and wrong. We appreciate your nuance and constructive leadership and your acumen as a writer. Otar Saldastani II. Otar, thank you for your exceptional wit and passion for facts and statistics. We appreciate your intellect and your discipline as a critical thinker. I would like to ask the ninth grade graduates to stand. I now present you the graduated ninth grade class of 2020. Graduates, please be seated.
Hi everyone, I'm Raina Hanaway, president of Shore's Board of Trustees. I have the special privilege today of taking the time to specially recognize a family whose final graduate brings the total number of student years at Shore to 30 or greater. This morning, we ask Kate and Drew Hoffman to please stand and be recognized. Kate and Drew, the parents of four students at Shore, complete 42 years of children at Shore as their daughter Meg graduates today. Thank you so much to the Hoffman family for your many years of support and commitment to Shore. This tradition is referred to as the Run for the Roses. We can't wait to share our special bouquet with you when you are here on campus. Before I sign off, I'd also like to extend my congratulations to each of our graduates today on behalf of the entire Shore Board of Trustees. Well done, congratulations.
I am fond of an ancient folktale about the essence of character, the choices you make when nobody is watching. The story is set in the East and features an emperor who was looking among the youth of his land for a candidate to replace him. As a test of their character, he gave them each a seed and instructed them to plant the seed and bring the pot back to him. Many of the children soon reported growing trees, flowers, and gorgeous bushes. But little Ling saw nothing growing in his pot. At the appointed time, Ling brought the empty pot back to the emperor, feeling sure that the leader would consider him a failure. But to his astonishment, the emperor chose him to be the replacement. As it turns out, all of the seeds had been boiled so they would not grow. The trees, flowers, and bushes that the others had grown were through deception. Only little Ling had been honest enough to bring back an empty pot. The moral of this story is that honor and reward will come to those who demonstrate the finest character. On the surface, this is a tale about what did not grow in Ling's pot. But I want us to now consider the story behind the story, the unseen growth that must have occurred in order to make Ling's moment possible. We know that Ling chose something on the face of challenge. But what prepared him to make that choice? Was it simply luck that this young boy took the right, albeit somewhat difficult, path? I would submit to you that in order to manage that particular moment, Ling had been in training. He had been shaped by the people and experiences that he had in his life. It is highly likely that there were times when Ling made the wrong choice and learned from his mistakes. In order for Ling to make the right choice with the emperor, he had to train his character muscle in much the same way that you have trained yours at Shore. Today, your graduation day, I cannot help but consider all of the ways in which your muscles have been trained. For all of your time at Shore, you have prepared for this moment, the moment in which you would launch into the next important phase of your education and your development. In essence, you have been in workout mode, training and growing your character muscles all along the way. And we know that you're ready. Your training is not complete, but you are ready to take the next step. I hope you will take a moment right now to turn and thank those with whom you are watching for their role in helping you grow. On behalf of your teachers, I want to thank you for the privilege of being your guides and your coaches. Thank you for the lessons that you have taught us. Know that this will always be your home and that you will likely be the only graduates that finished the year in the full spirit of SHORE's Community Code online. I look forward to seeing all of you soon in order to present you with your diplomas. In addition, I would like to offer you a very special invitation. Next year, on June 9, 2021, I hope you will consider joining me at graduation. We will offer all of the 2020 graduates special seating so that we can honor you and acknowledge you in person as a whole community. But as of today, you are now SHORE graduates, joining a long history of SHORE alums who came before you. And you will set the path for those who follow. To our audience, I want to thank you for sharing this special graduation day with us. Our ceremony will conclude with the traditional SHORE benediction performed by the Puelle Cantantes, a cappellas, and the SHORE staff. We would like to encourage our alums to join us for this benediction. Best wishes and heartfelt congratulations to our graduates. We are so incredibly proud of you. Thank you.